I think I'll sum up and take a few reflections if time permits. So to sum up, on day one in session one, we talked briefly about value, right? So let me again revise it, that value of a unit is its participation in the larger order. So the larger order means something that larger harmonious system. So for example, for myself, my family is the larger order. For my family, the family cluster is the larger order. For family cluster, the village is the larger order, or the group of clusters is the larger order, and so on and so forth. Now, if you look at any kind of unit, let's say a pen. So the value of a pen is that it helps to write. So the value of pen is its participation in education, which is the larger order, isn't it? Similarly, value of water is that it quenches thirst. So it is participating in health. So this way, every unit has its participation, and every unit, as we saw right now, is recognizing the relation and fulfilling it. The way I start writing with a pen, you know, the ink of the pen sticks to the paper and allows me to write, right? So the ink is also participating with the paper. Pen is also participating within me, you know, with me. So all the units are participating, and that participation, rightly understood, is the value. Similarly, if you look at yourself, there are activities of desire, thought, expectation in you, and value of your activity is the participation in the harmony within you. So the value of desire would be that, you know, desires are such which are not contradictory, right? They are in harmony. The thoughts are such which are not contradictory mutually. They are in harmony. The expectations are such which are not contradicting, you know, either desire or thought or any other expectation, and they are in harmony. So my activities, you know, have a value because they participate in my harmony, right? So this is something to be termed as value in the self. So happiness is one outcome. Peace is one outcome. Satisfaction is one outcome. And something that we discussed right now, the realization understanding. So when I have the realization of submergence of nature in space, right? And then I will understand the harmony of the four orders in detail, that gives me the state of bliss. So if you look at myself, right, the values would be happiness, peace, satisfaction, and bliss. Similarly, value of your body is participation in your activities as a human being. You know? So we talked about health and self-regulation. So the body is able to participate, you know, in a larger order, and that larger order is the human being, where self is also there, body is also there. Similarly, your value in the family, your participation in the harmony in the family. So you are valuable to your family if your presence adds to the harmony in the family, isn't it? If the presence of a human being creates disharmony, or we generally term the person as invaluable, you know, or not of value. If a child is sitting in the class and the presence of the child in the class is adding to the, you know, harmony in the class, then the child is valuable to the class. Similarly, the teacher, you know, faculty who is working in a department, the presence of the faculty is adding to the harmony of the department. That faculty is valuable to the department. Similarly, your value in the society is your participation in the harmony in the society, in fulfilling the four human goals. When you go to live in some colony and that colony becomes better than earlier, it becomes greener, the relationship with the, you know, families in the colony grows, you know, then you are valuable to the society, to the colony. Isn't it? Similarly, your value in the nature is your participation in the harmony in the nature. So that is all that we have to see. We have to make out what is my role, what is my participation, right? In at all levels of my living. Your value in the existence is your participation in the coexistence, right? So in this workshop, we try to explore the universal values of a human being. And at every point when we were discussing, we saw that we are going by the basic guidelines, isn't it? So the more we are able to see the values, we can see that they are very much universal, irrespective of caste, creed, gender, community, sect, whatever. They are very much universal. Only that I have to see it and I have to align with it. This is something which I have to do as a human being. So to sum up the whole thing, so you know, here we have the levels listed, which we discussed, right? So we talked about four levels where we are clubbing nature and existence together. And when we were talking about human being, we talked about the self and body together. Now we can explore into the, or we have seen the relationship or the potential at every level, you know, and here are the details. So we saw that existence is coexistence. So there is coexistence there, and there is potential for human being to realize this, right? Now that same coexistence when it reflects at the level of nature, we can see that there is mutual fulfillment among the four orders of nature. So it is by virtue of this coexistence only that the plant is fulfilling to the soil, and the soil is fulfilling to the plant. You know, we need to only look into it, appreciate it. It's very much there. In fact, when you are able to see the reality as it is, you know, you see that it is very much there. Why to question it? Why to, you know, feel surprised about it? It is very much there. Only that I was not able to see it rightly, isn't it? So this mutual fulfillment in the nature, you know, is by virtue of this coexistence. It is only a reflection of this coexistence. And by that only there is harmony and relationship, right? And the potential being, potential for human being is there to be in harmony. Similarly, at the level of society, and we talked about these four human goals, right? Understanding, prosperity, fearlessness, coexistence. And these are again a reflection of coexistence. So right understanding would mean being able to realize the coexistence. Prosperity would mean being able to fulfill the coexistence of self and body rightly. Fearlessness would mean coexistence of self and self in the society. And already there is coexistence here, right? So the human nature relationship and the potential through participation of individuals and families. In various societal systems, right? So these are the details that we discussed. Then in the family, we all are coexisting, you know? Only that I have to align myself with the coexistence which is already there. So trust when we discuss. So when I say that I want to make the other happy, the other also wants to make me happy. Ultimately, we are trying to reflect on this coexistence that I am, you know, for your happiness, you are for my happiness. We are coexisting. Respect, you know, again, is a reflection of coexistence, and same with love. So all the feelings that we saw, we discussed, are ultimately a reflection of this coexistence. So we discussed about the human-human relationship and the potential for acting, feeling the self for mutual happiness. We also looked into the coexistence of self and body, that body is my instrument, it is a material entity, and the conscious entity. And through that, we could explore into self-regulation and health. Then we can see, as I mentioned now, in a state of continuous happiness, we are having the state of happiness, peace, satisfaction, and bliss. So bliss is when I get the realization of coexistence in existence, and on that basis, I'm able to understand the harmony in the nature in completeness. So that is the state of bliss. With that, I'm able to have my desires which are completely in coherence with coexistence. You know? Now, no longer my desires are preconditioned or enslaved by sensation, right? And that is when I feel satisfied. An example would be when I'm able to see that physical facility is required only for my body, you know? Then I feel satisfied in terms of physical facility. I can see that, yes, I have enough. You know? Similarly, when I'm having the right understanding, the understanding of coexistence, then I have peace in my thoughts. Now there's no longer any struggle or turmoil or, you know, noise in my thoughts. I'm at peace. And it reflects in my expectation also. I'm able to see that the way I'm related, I'm able to fulfill it. So it reflects in my, you know, as happiness in my expectation. And there is a will to live with continuous happiness in me very much there, right? And I have the potential for right understanding also, right feeling also, right thought also, you know, which can enable mutually fulfilling behavior and work. So we have been exploring about these in detail one by one. So we started from exploring the human being, right? Then we went on to the family, society, nature. But some of you see is here. So whatever we have discussed so far, you know, is only a reflection of this coexistence. This is the essence of all that we have discussed so far. So these are the universal values, right, that we have been trying to explore. So what program of action, you know, comes out of it? So program of action at the individual level, for example, for each one of us sitting here, you know, would be to understand harmony and to live in harmony at all levels of our being, be it individual or family or society or nature or existence, you know. This is something that I need to do at the individual level. And for that, the basic task is to start this process of self-exploration. So whatever is presented is in the form of proposals for you to explore. You know? So through this verification, you know, we can have the right understanding of harmony, we can have the feeling and thought of harmony, and we can have harmonious behavior, work, and participation in the larger order. So I need to discover what I really want to be, my natural acceptance, my intention. So this is something that we initiated, you know, in this workshop. Right, and we see that it never, you know, stops. Once the self-exploration starts in you, once you are able to see that there is something called natural acceptance in you, you cannot just move your attention away from it. It is very much there in you every moment, you know, whether you are aware to that level or not, but this will keep on reflecting you. So once this exploration starts in you, very much continues in you. But to make it, you know, more grave or more, you know, sincere, what we need to do is we need to have self-awareness. We have to be aware of our desire, our thought and expectation every moment, right? So no longer when you are feeling angry, you can ignore it simply, but rather you will try to see what is happening inside you, whether your imagination is enslaved by preconditioning or sensation, you know, or is it coming from right understanding? So this is something to be done in the next. With this self-exploration, we need to be need to have self-awareness, where we are able to be aware of every thought, every desire, every expectation in me. And when I am able to do this one and two, then I am able to evaluate myself rightly. I am able to evaluate my desire, my thought, my expectation on the basis of my natural acceptance. And this gets purified, what I am, you know, the set of my desire, thought and expectation, my competence level slowly gets transformed. So the more I am able to do this, the more I discover my natural acceptance, myself gets purified. You know, it becomes more and more coherent with my natural acceptance. So this is the guiding factor for me. So this is something that I need to do at the individual level. Now, when we go to do at the level of society, so one program which can be done is people's education program. So if you look at it for the past 20 years, we'll say, you know, we have been doing this people's education program. 10 years back, it got included, or let's say 15 years back, it got included formally in some courses, and 10 years back, it started spreading to universities. So people's education means that we are able to discuss this content with, you know, people from different segments of the society, you know, different professions, different, you know, ways of living, right? So we can discuss with parents, we can discuss with teachers, we can discuss with policymakers, and so many ways are there, right? Let me just mention here that we have also conducted workshops for the jail inmates, you know, at various places. We have conducted workshops for villagers, for the city people, the policymakers, the bureaucrats. So this is something called people's education, where you are able to take this content forward, you know, to different segments of the society. But this is not very structured, right? Now, when you have this education sanskar program, it becomes structured. For example, we have included this presently in the higher education. In technical education, slowly this has to go into the higher education, then it has to go to higher secondary, then primary, right? So people with right understanding and right feeling, who are the people with definite human conduct, and then have the competence to participate in the universal human order, can develop the courses in academic curriculum, socially relevant projects, conducive environment. So here we can see, you know, there is a lot of scope for creativity here. AICT is also talking about giving internship after every year. So after the first year, the students can go for, let's say, social internship. After second year, they can go for another kind of internship. After third year, they can go for industrial internship. So like when we have social internship, we can push this kind of content that the students go to a proper some segment of the society, they are able to interact there. Maybe they are able to conduct some workshop there, right? So here, you know, there's a lot of scope. Then moving ahead of education, we can work on all the five dimensions, be it justice, be it health, be it preservation, be it production, be it exchange. Then we can have a program for fulfillment of the human goal. So we are this way, moving through education, we are able to penetrate into other dimensions of the society so that we can work to fulfill all the four human goals. And there is a scope for going from family to the world family this way. Now, when you work at the people's education program level, then let's say in 10 years, you are able to transform yourself to a point where you can see that, no, this is the only program for me. And in the next 10 years, you are able to transform 10 more people. So if we move this way, then we can transform, or at least bring to that level of transformation, 1,000 crores of people. And presently in the world, if you see, there are 777 crore people, or 778, something like that. You know? Now, if we have this program included in education, then within 20 to 50 years, this can very much happen. So the way we conducted, you know, like this is ninth workshop, another workshop is going on, the 10th workshop in this summer. So this way, you know, we can reach out to the universities, we can reach out to the policymakers in the universities, the, you know, who are providing the education. So Effectively, if this program is implemented within 20 to 50 years, we can transform, you know, the society, because this will penetrate into every segment. As we discussed earlier also, that when we are taking this input into the higher education, we are taking this input to the would-be parents, would-be teachers, would-be professionals, would-be policymakers, isn't it? Right? So we are able to penetrate in all directions. And when we have this program implemented at all the five dimensions, then even it will take less time, right? So this way, if you move, you know, this is very much achievable. But the core point is you have to work upon yourself. So while working for the society or for education, if we miss out the task that we have to accomplish within ourselves, if I do not look at my level of understanding, if I do not try to transform myself, then I cannot be a pillar of this kind of program. So ultimately, it boils down to ensuring that understanding in you, right? The more you are able to ensure the right understanding in you, the more you are able to participate naturally at higher level, but you know, in the larger order. So in closing, I'll just say that this online workshop was just an invitation for the 8-day faculty development program for student induction. So if you can see the possibility of this content and process, if you can see your own potential and the potential of your family, your institution, your society, your country, then you will renew your commitment to make the necessary effort for it. As a teacher, we have the highest possibility to realize this potential and to be of help to hundreds and thousands of other human beings to develop to their full personality, to be a source of a just and equitable society, right? So this is something that we have been discussing in detail. So it has been an enriching experience for all of us, right? So thanks from my side. It was a nice occasion to be with you. Online, we could not see each other, but we could interact a lot, share a lot. So a lot of thanks from my side. And now we can hear from you. So I think Gajendra sir will be inviting Dr. Shishi Gaur, who will be sharing about the details of the induction program.